Hi, and welcome to Introduction to Periodicals. We'll be covering what is a periodical, what the different kinds of periodicals are, why you would use those different kinds, and how to tell them apart, as well as how to find the articles. Periodicals are publications that are published in a series over a period of time. They may be available online, or in print, or both. So for example, we have El País, which is the major newspaper in Spain. It's available in print, and it's available online. There are several different kinds of periodicals out there. There are periodicals that cover news and current events, for example, newspapers, commentary and opinion magazines, and then there are newsletters, which are often from organizations. There are popular and special interest magazines. These are written by journalists or professional writers. They tend to use easy language, and they almost never cite their sources. You'll see lots of colorful ads, some of which may be unrelated to the subject. You can buy them at bookstores or even stores like Target or Walmart. The articles tend to be short, although there are some that have slightly longer articles. And many art magazines you may be interested in fall into this category. So, for example, Art News, Art Forum, Juxtapose, and Art in America. There's a category you may not be familiar with called trade and professional journals. These are written by and for professionals in a particular field like advertising, industrial design, or even library. They cover business or industry information like trends, new products, new techniques, sometimes even jobs. Occasionally, they'll cite their sources, but for the most part, they don't. If there are ads, they're usually related to the field in some way. These magazines are not usually available in stores. You frequently have to be a member of a professional organization, or you have to subscribe to them. There are a few exceptions to that, and one of those is Variety, the entertainment trade magazine. The last category we'll talk about are scholarly academic journals. These are written by and for academics and scholars to share their ideas and research. They tend to use difficult academic language, and the articles tend to be rather long. They use full citations for all of their sources. They will almost never have ads, and if they do, they're for things like books or conferences. They're available by subscription or by organizational membership. Occasionally, you might find one in an academic bookstore. They do contain book reviews and editorials. And while these are very useful, they're not considered scholarly articles. I like to think of it as a periodical spectrum. You'll have some that are popular, some that kind of ease over towards trade or professional, and then trade or professional journals that sort of ease over towards scholarly. The CCAD library subscribes to almost 100 periodicals in paper, although through our electronic databases like JSTOR or Academic Search Complete, you'll have access to thousands more. Paper periodicals in our library are organized alphabetically, and this is true whether or not we're talking about the newest issues or older back issues that have been bound. So how do you find articles? Many magazine articles are indexed in subscription databases like JSTOR, Academic Search Complete, or Art and Architecture Source. We also have something called OneSearch, which will search many of these databases at the same time. However, there are some magazines that aren't indexed anywhere. You may have to look through the physical print issues to find articles that you're looking for. If you need help, you can always ask a librarian, and we'll see what we can do to help you find what you're looking for. You might be thinking, why not just use Google Scholar? Well, you can, but just realize that Google Scholar doesn't have the same standards as an academic database. This has led to bogus papers showing up in Google Scholar results. You may be able to get a book or article you find in Google Scholar through either our library, you can borrow it through OhioLINK, or you might find the article in one of our full-text databases. It's always a good idea to check to see if you can get it for free, because otherwise, Google Scholar will send you to a page like this, where they expect you to pay for it, and paying should be your very last option. So if you have questions about doing research with periodicals, let us know. We can help. We're located in the lower level of Kinzani, or you can email us at library@ccad.edu or give us a call at 614-222-3273.